Ladies and gentlemen, following on the news given in our bulletin a moment ago, the Government Meteorological Bureau has requested the large observatories of the country to keep an astronomical watch on any further disturbances occurring on the planet Mars. Due to the unusual nature of this occurrence, we have arranged an interview with a noted astronomer, Professor Pearson, who will give us his views.
System connected, my condition detected early. Preschool daydream, space cadet face set on stun, staring at the sky, barely coherent, head bled thoughts that were fairly transparent. Clear, so use your rear view mirror when you peer through here. Steer clear of the asteroids, blaster toys with the idiotic robotic supersonic sound barrier breaker. Hitchhike a galaxy guide when you slide through the area sector. Star chart finder, beam me off the spaceship, drop it in the basement. Science fiction fiction translated on track. Hit like hail mop, drop down and explode. Overload the navigation on my face, it will be looking at the star.
Is brought to you by the letter K, A, N, S, E to the R. Travel through my mind, my thoughts revolve around stars. Travel through my mind, my thoughts revolve around stars. This is brought to you by the letter K, A, N, S, E to the R. Travel through my mind, my thoughts revolve around stars. Travel through my mind, my thoughts revolve around stars.
I chose my destination, I've been patient, done with waiting. Ancient instincts take over the map, the constellation. Individual space station takes flight like light speed. Despite the life I lead and all this trauma, my flight it seems to miniaturize. When it's your eyes, leaving the Earth's surface, the universe is soulless. To stop all of the urges, no feeling is as great as this. Utter complete weightlessness, zero gravity, the comparison. Maybe naked bliss, free from all the rat race. Denying what I felt, and it all fades away when flying around Orion's belt. The cosmonaut adventurer that sent for a retrieval of a more in-depth account, bounce and renounce all other people and left this mess behind for the prospect of solitude all in due time. But my mind says to follow through, traveling through the vastest reaches of space that's ever known. This is where I belong and I'm never going home.
This is brought to you by the letter K, A-N-S-E to the R. Travel through my mind, my thoughts revolve around stars. Travel through my mind, my thoughts revolve around stars. This is brought to you by the letter K, A-N-S-E to the R. Travel through my mind, my thoughts revolve around stars. Travel through my mind, my thoughts revolve around stars.
Interplanetary microscopic sine waves carry evidence that there's life beyond the sector that we're living in. Believe me when I say we're not alone, I mean the whole universe is overpopulated. And our arrival's highly anticipated as we make contact like Jodie Foster. Traveling faster than the speed of light, encountering alienated life forms trapped in a ice storm 10,000 years into the future. Envision the sixth dimension as my mental universe is contaminated, complicated when I'm inventing powerful phrases to reach the deepest and darkest places. Species of different faces congregating the latest, discovering new planets, cyber age gadgets allow average individuals to travel through the tunnels of our imagination, but never leaving Earth. Just a subtle sound of concentration for what it's worth.
He's the satellite of the Earth, as surely as the moon. As he floats through the black hush of space at 17,000 miles per hour, led step by step to the day when man, for the first time, would dare to break away from the possessiveness of his home planet. Then came that critical period of getting back. Now, all re-entries are a bit hairy, since the heat shield of the capsule is red hot from friction with what we call the sensible atmosphere. And your life depends on getting the drogue parachute out on time. With communications blacked out,